Hello guys, and welcome back. Today is another scenery update, and it's sort of scenery, I guess. Before we get started, really, as you can see, power's off on the layout currently. As you can see, back there, we've got the roundhouse. Now, before, this didn't happen, but I recently put lights in. So now, the roundhouse is all, like, lit up and stuff. And yeah, there's some crap in the back there. But you can see the roundhouse is all lit up and stuff. So, it looks super good. And I just thought I'd show you guys that, as it is technically part of the scenery. But actually, what I'm going to be working on today, if we come on over here, is I'm going to be working on this chunk of scenery. Basically, from where those tunnels go this way, all the way, except for that, I don't know what I'm going to do with that. That used to be one of those oil pumps, and used to, like, move and stuff, and then it broke. And then everything to about there. Oh! I completely forgot to show you guys this, and I'll get to that in just a second, but yeah. So, but anyway, that's where I'm going to be working on. Just going to completely redo the scenery. Now, I'm not going to do things like weather that water tower quite yet. Well, I don't know, I might. Actually, yeah, I think I will weather that just a little bit with my airbrush. Because it needs it. It looks too plasticky. But we'll get to that in a little bit. So basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove all this stuff, vacuum it, all the ballast up, and then I'm going to show you guys what that looks like. But if we go over there for a minute, if you guys remember, a while back, turn this light on. If you guys remember, a while back, I did a scenery video where I did this section and then that. Well, what I did, as you guys can see, I have ballast. We have ballast. This has been ballasted. Let me actually show you guys what I used. I don't really like it a whole lot. I think it could use a bit of black. But we've got... Oh, right, it doesn't say on there. What this is a mix of fine and medium buff colored ballast. I don't understand how buff is a color, but whatever. And then the other thing we've got here is medium gray ballast. And, yeah, I just mixed a little bit of this in with this. In this baggie, came out looking a lot like that. I glued it down and everything. It's still a little bit, still moves around a little bit with my finger. I might put another coat of glue, but my plan is, you see, I've got it all ballasted until right here. My plan is, originally this was ballast here. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put, like, a walkway. Because, you see, there's this platform over here, and eventually I'm going to extend it out this way. Is the plan anyway. Get another platform. But you see, what that would mean is you'd have passengers walking over the tracks whenever there's not a train in the way. So what I'm thinking is, I'm gonna get, like, walkway, like, something kind of like this, sort of. And there used to be some here, but I pulled it off, obviously. But there used to be something like that there. But I think I'm gonna do, like, a lot more of it. I don't know yet. I don't know if I'm going to do it like brick color like this or gray like concrete. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. But so those are just some updates, the ballast, the roundhouse lights, and what I'm going to do with this. Now let's get on to, and that's just stuff I've been doing over the course of the last several weeks. Now let's get over to this over here. This is, like I said, this is the next section I'm going to work on, so I'm going to go ahead and take it apart, strip it down, and vacuum up all the ballast and stuff, and then I will see you guys whenever that is done. And that's going to be a very long process, so it'll probably be an hour or two for me. So, I'll see you guys whenever that's all done. Okay, guys, it's been a couple hours, and I had dinner, and as you can see, well, there's a lot missing. But, if you look closely, let me angle the camera here and zoom in. See, we still got all this that didn't really come off, which that's going to be a problem. But oh well. So I got everything off. This house, it's like attached by a wire because of the light. So I can't actually pull it all the way off. But yeah, I've effectively rendered my vacuum useless at the moment because the bag needs to be changed out. Man, does the bag need to be changed out. So the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to have to ballast all this thing before I start putting anything back. And that's something I didn't do previously because I didn't have ballast. Now I now have ballast. So, all of this... gets to get ballasted. Oh, and that track there, but that track there is special. I'm doing something special with that. See, and let me explain that real quick. So I have this locomotive here. It's old, super old. It's made by a company that no longer exists. And, well, this is actually just the shell of this thing. You'll notice it's missing several, drive rod assembly bits. So, it no longer functions, and I'm gonna weather this thing as well. So, but it no longer functions, so I put it back together, sort of, and just sort of had it sitting there with the tender as well. And then my brother comes along. He gets a brand new kit to build a car. And he beats the crap out of it. My brother did this. He beats the crap out of it and makes it look awful. Then I weathered it. He broke it up and busted it up and everything. And it basically looks awful. But that's a good thing that he did that. See, you got the walkways coming up. You got holes all over this thing. This is all broken and stuff. But that's a good thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to have our locomotive there. We're going to have our tender behind it. And I don't really know how well you guys can see that. Let me move the camera. We're going to have the tender behind it. And then we're going to have this boxcar here. Oh, scheisse. We're going to have this boxcar here, so it's going to kind of look like that, and it's going to be on an abandoned piece of track. I saw a video recently of how to make an abandoned piece of track, and I really wanted to do that, and I have a locomotive that does not work. It literally is weight and the shell, the outside shell of a light Mikado, and that's all it is, really, because my grandpa gut it whenever it quit working. He gut it. And now it doesn't work. We have a very similar one. Actually, it's the exact same thing, except it's a different road number. And it still works. My brother sort of got it working, and we're working on it to get it working again. But, yeah. Like I said, made by a company that doesn't exist anymore. They're the company that used to make... So, you know, if you know the Durango and Silverton Narrow Gauge Railway, you know that they have HO scale... they got HO scale, like, merchandise that says Durango and Silverton on the side, yeah? Well, this is what they used to be. Now they're Bachmann. Now they're Bachmann 280 consolidations. They used to be, I don't even remember the company, but something or other, Light Mikados. But that company went out of business. We still have in operation, I believe, two locomotives by that company. One of them is a Light Mikado, the sister of this locomotive. That one's 486, the other one is 480. And the other one is an 080 locomotive. And they're basically, all the locomotives of this company were all basically the same style. But anyway, so that's my plan, is for right there, is take that, this track here, this siding, and make it an abandoned piece of track. I think that's going to be really cool, personally. And yeah, it'll be cool, hopefully. And it'll give me a spot to put a dead locomotive, all rusted up and everything. I was going to have it just sitting around in the yard, but, I mean, I don't have space in my yard. So, So it's just going to go on this siding here. And my brother, you know, made a old broken boxcar. So we have something that'll go behind it now as well. And I don't know, it might be, I might reverse it to where the locomotive's facing this way. I don't really know. But it's going to be an abandoned piece of track, and it's going to look really great. So I'm probably not going to work on this again tonight. I might ballast a little bit, but I'm probably not going to work on this again tonight. So I will see you guys, for me, what it'll be tomorrow. I don't know, hang on, can you guys see? Let me zoom in. Yeah. The sun is setting, so I'll see you guys tomorrow. You guys will see me in just a second, but, oh, and just real quick, I just want to show you guys the mess I made of my space. Over here, on this windowsill, there's a bunch of trees and stuff I pulled off of this, and over here, there's, like, a bunch of buildings and stuff. Also, I decided, in another video, I'm gonna weather this, but, you'll see the weathered version, you'll see that weathered go back on the layout. So I'm gonna weather that tomorrow in another video. So, I'm just gonna give you guys a nice little view of the sunset. And I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow, but for you, it's just going to be whenever I'm done waving my hand. It's not going. It's not. I'm just messing with you guys. I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, guys. So it took me like a very, very, very long time, long enough that I don't even remember what I said in the last clip. But I finally got the whole thing like ballasted and everything. and really, all right, whatever. Anyway, but I finally got the whole thing ballasted. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put the buildings back to try and figure out, okay, where do I want things? And as you can see, like I said, this building, I couldn't move. Anyway, but, so the next thing I'm going to do, like I said, is I'm going to put all the buildings back so we can see kind of what I want to do with it, because I don't really know what I want to do yet. And, like, where the grass needs to go. And also so that I can clean up the roads. This stuff here and over there, that's dirt road. So, let me do that. Okay, anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and do that and then figure out what I want to do. And then I'm going to do the grass and everything. I guess that'll be the next clip. I'll see you guys in a second. Okay, guys, yes, I'm holding my camera this time. First of all, it's really dark outside. It's getting late, but I got the thing all grassed up and stuff, and it's all looking good. I think I know where I'm going to put stuff. And I put this, I don't know why that's there, but I put this here as kind of like how I think I'm going to have it. As you can see, I got like a tree on in the middle of the track, and I got this thing's kind of falling off and stuff, boxcar. And yeah, I think it's going to look a little bit like that. This is just kind of to get a general idea, because I have no idea what I'm doing yet for the abandoned track. I did a pretty poor job ballasting that section to make it look like the ballast is all like washed away and stuff. And I put like some grass on it, and as you can see, bushes, and like I said, that tree. And I'm gonna put a couple more trees in between the two rails along that spot. I think it turned out pretty good. I've already got the thing there right now, so don't really get to see the thing. Really, you know what the abandoned track looks like. I might show you a bit from over there. Hang on, let me zoom in, actually. This is blurry. Anyway, I'm sure there's a good shot in there somewhere. That's basically what it looks like. Also, there's a house Let me zoom in on the spot. There's a house. It used to be right there. I've temporarily got it on this here shelf. This used to be over there. Now, I'm thinking, because, I mean, that's like an industrial area over there, so I think it's going to go, like, about right there or something. So something like that. I don't exactly know yet. That's just sort of randomly placed there in the general location because it's, you know, I have a camera in my hand and I'm way over here. It's like a full arm's length, but I think that's kind of where it's going to go. I just don't like it being over there, and I figured, you know, we can fit another house here. I might as well put one. So, yeah, as I said, though, it is getting dark, so in the morning, I'm going to start working on trees and bushes. I'm going to put our buildings back. Trees, bushes, and then people, and then I'm done. And cars and stuff. And then I'm done. So, I will see you guys tomorrow. Of course, for you, it's just going to be an instant, but I got to take the long way around. Then again, I guess this is going to get uploaded in about a week. So, it's currently Thursday. Oh, crap, it's Thursday. Which means I need to get a video up. And it's really late already. And, well, I'll see what I can do. It's only... I don't know what time it is. Anyway, enough of my rambling. Tomorrow, I'll do more work on it. Try to get this thing finished up, because tomorrow's Saturday. No, wait, today's Friday. Because tomorrow's Saturday, and then I only have half a day, because the next day is Sunday. And then I go back home, and school starts again, and oh, that sucks, and I do not want to go back. Whatever. The point is, I'm going to see you guys in just a second, except for me. I will have showered and slept. I need to shower real bad. I smell. Anyway, yeah, you guys can probably smell me from, you know, wherever you're sitting watching this video. Okay, enough. I'm done joking. I'm going to come back tomorrow and wrap this thing up. I don't know how long this video is getting. Because I haven't started editing yet, but I'll get to that later. Anyway, so, I'm gonna see you guys in just a second. Well, guys, it's, for basically the first thing in the morning. And, I've already... See, it's daytime now. See, I've already got it all kind of done. You got trees, you got stuff. This is kind of... abandoned train and track is just kind of hidden, but it is there and it looks really good. We've got bushes and stuff around it if we look closely. Partly because of the shadow. Let me just move the camera, light and zoom in a bit. See, you got all sorts of stuff there. Although I do think it's funny that it's right next to the school. That's the school. Also, I put this diner here. I don't know if it looks any good. I don't know if I'm going to keep it there. I just sort of placed it there to try to figure out, oh, do I want to have it there or not? And stuff. But it, you know, it really looks good. And of course, I think, I'm not 100% sure on this, I think that my brother is going to put a... another old rusted out locomotive right here. I'm not 100% sure on this, but I think that's what he's gonna do. I don't know. We'll see how that goes. So I still need to put oh crap. I still need to put people and cars back, and then I'm done. So that's something. Then I'm done. Let's see. But it looks really good. Anyway, so I'm gonna see you guys in a second. I'm gonna put the people in the cars, and then, well, it'll be done, basically. And I'll give you one last final shot in my final thoughts. So I'll see you guys in just a second.
Okay, guys, so, the last thing I said was, that I was gonna put the people, and, like, put the people in the cars and stuff onto the layout, and, well, as you can see, this is an audio recording and a black screen. So as you can tell, well, I forgot to film that. I totally forgot, to film that. My brother was being annoying and stuff, so I forgot. Sorry. Oh well. I did manage to get all the people and the vehicles and stuff on there, and it looks really, really good. But I don't have any pictures, and I'm at my house in the at the moment. And for those of you who don't know, my layout is at my grandma's, because it was originally my grandpa's. He originally built it, and it was over there where he built it. So I can't always get over there. Otherwise, I'd go there right now and finish recording this. But anyway, at any rate, it looks really good. It's pretty safe to say it looks really good. I will mention this, though, if you are doing anything like this, be aware, you're gonna have to, whenever you ballast, you're gonna have to clean the track pretty good. For those of you who don't know, the layout has two loops, an outer loop, and an inner loop. And of course, the outer loop has a bigger, turn radius than the inner loop. The inner loop has tighter curves, so not everything can go on the inner loop. But literally everything that I have can go on the outer loop. Well, actually, I take that back, because my AC6000 has problems at switches. But that's irrelevant at the moment. But at the moment, nothing can go on the inner loop without stopping, losing track power. Evidently, I got a little bit too much glue on the track, on the rail. I thought I cleaned it off as good as I could. I did not. And it's going to take me probably a couple weeks to get that sorted. Only reason it's going to take me a couple weeks is because it takes me a long time to get over there and stuff. Also, something you guys should probably know. This, video, it is currently April, if I remember correctly, it is currently April 5th, and this video was recorded in March, 17, 18, 19, in that range. In next week's videos as well. Speaking of next week's videos, next week I intend to post two videos just because I have so many videos piling up. I currently can't make any new ones. So next week's videos, I'll be posting one of them on Tuesday and the next one on Thursday. So just look out for that. Next Tuesday and Thursday, I'll be posting next week's videos with an S. There'll be more than one. Anyway, that's gonna be it for this video. And those were also recorded in March. The reason why is that was spring break, and then I forgot to upload last week, if I remember correctly. Or no, I didn't forget to upload. I don't even remember. Yeah, I didn't forget to upload because I got the, scenery tutorial, the water scenery tutorial, which was a complete fail on my part. I definitely didn't do it right. anyway. But, let's see. That's gonna be it for this video. The big reason why I did, why they were recorded then, was because that was spring break for me, whenever I had a week off of school. Obviously, I'm going to record as many videos as I possibly can while I have a week off of school, and the majority of which is spent in the same house as the layout. So, yeah. So, I pre-recorded a bunch of videos, and one of them, obviously, is this video. The next two are going out next week. But, yeah. That is going to be it for this video, though. Thank you guys for watching. If you are not subscribed to my channel already, please do so. Hit that subscribe button. And also hit that like button to be very much appreciated. Very much appreciated. And that little bell icon, you can hit that as well to get notified whenever I post videos. Most of the time, though, it is going to be on Wednesday, but like I said about next week, I'm posting on Tuesday and Thursday next week. But then after that, it goes back to Wednesday. The fact of the matter is, though, sometimes I'll post other videos, like on, it was, I think, Saturday, I posted a review. So, I'm gonna try to post on mostly on Wednesdays, but I might also post on other days as well, depending on the content, and depending on this and that and the other. So, hit that bell icon to get notifications of when I upload videos. And one last thing, if you have any questions at all, feel free to put them in the comments. I'd be happy to answer any questions you have for me. Totally open to all discussions. I can't promise that I will comment back in a timely manner. It might be the next day or a day or two, but I will comment back eventually, so just keep that in mind. I'll try to comment back the same day, but it's difficult. Anyway, but like I said, thanks for watching, and we will see you next week for some more train-related videos. Bye, guys.